New AI supercomputer 5 times bigger than the human brain with 500 trillion parameters. The new machine from Graphcore could be able to support AIs that have 500 trillion parameters. That is 5 times more than the human brain and is estimated to be 10 times more efficient in terms of computational speed. The company claims that this will not be a one-off item. Instead, they plan to produce this AI supercomputer in large quantities to meet the demands of companies, institutions, and universities. Graphcore is an artificial intelligence chipmaker, which is among the UK's most valuable private companies, and has announced plans to create this extremely intelligent AI computer to rival the computational power of the human brain. Despite the promises that supercomputers hold, they currently aren't nearly as fast or effective as the human brain. Human brains are able to process over 100 trillion parameters, which is an impressive level of computing power that hasn't yet been replicated by any silicon-based computer. The computer from Graphcore is scheduled to go into production in just 2 years and would cost $120 million to purchase, which is a cost that makes it affordable to universities and private companies. In context, $120 million is less than the $1 billion needed to construct one of the world's most powerful supercomputers called the Fugaku. This AI supercomputer will be built on a technological breakthrough that has revolutionized its AI chip architecture, which will allow it to handle AI models that have 500 trillion parameters. The computer will also be able to perform at over 10 exaflops, which is equal to 10 billion billion computations per second. For reference, the human brain is estimated to compute at a speed of 1 exaflop. The computer is based on a brand new kind of silicon processor that Graphcore has designed, which could be an additional win for Graphcore as it seeks to surpass its main competitor, NVIDIA. American-based NVIDIA is currently the dominant player in the market for AI chips. However, competitors such as Graphcore, Cerebras, and Sambanova have come up with specific chips made to handle AI calculations. The entirely new silicon processing device that Graphcore will be using is a 3D chip on which two pieces of silicon wafers are conjoined. Graphcore claims that this will give the processor a 40% increase in performance and 16% higher power efficiency than its earlier models. Graphcore calls this the Good Computer, which is named after Jack Good, who was one of the pioneers of computer science and the development of the first electronic computer. Whether Graphcore will be able to pull off their delivery of the Good Computer is yet to be seen. Other research projects, like Manchester University's Spinnaker supercomputer, have tried to understand how to imitate humans' brains, not only in terms of size, but also in terms of how it can transmit large amounts of data quickly. The advances made by Graphcore demonstrate that certain power limitations that have held back artificial intelligence until now are beginning to be overtaken, which could pave the way for a supercomputing device to enable artificial general intelligence. New AI-powered exoskeleton. Researchers from the University of Alberta are looking to redefine medical aid for people with mobility issues by combining artificial intelligence and exoskeleton technology. The group is hoping to use machine learning to analyze specific walking patterns of individuals to develop customized robot exoskeletons. The robotics help to amplify the motions so that users require less effort while the exoskeleton takes more of the load off of the user. Although exoskeleton technology isn't something new, the researchers at Edmonton believe that they are the first to realize the potential of combining it with artificial intelligence. The exoskeleton learns from the person so that all the movements from the person are recorded and used to update the machine learning algorithm in real time. In this way, this assistive technology can be flexible in multiple scenarios. This can include situations like transitions between different modes of walking, or walking on different types of terrain, or changing from walking patterns that are ascending or descending. The AI-powered exoskeleton could also be used to aid in rehabilitation after serious injuries. This device allows users to keep walking while compensating for what they can't do, but also reduces that level of assistance gradually so that they contribute more and more. Although the researchers are still in the initial stage, the team believes that with enough time and energy, their newer, more precise device will make a difference in helping people with mobility issues. Artificial intelligence and ECG heart trace predicts prediabetes and diabetes. An AI algorithm trained on the characteristics of the individual heartbeats recorded by an electrocardiogram is able to accurately identify prediabetes and diabetes, as published in the journal BMJ Innovations. If the method is validated in more studies, This method can be utilized to test for the disease in low-resource environments, such as in third-world hospitals. About 463 million adults across the globe were diagnosed with diabetes in the year 2019, and getting the disease diagnosed at an early stage is crucial to avoid developing grave health issues. Currently, diagnosis is largely based on the measuring levels of blood glucose. This measurement procedure is not just invasive, but also difficult to conduct at scale with limited resources. Functional and structural changes within the cardiovascular system can be seen in the early stages, even before any indicative changes in blood glucose levels, which are evident in an ECG cardiac trace. The researchers wanted to investigate whether machine learning methods could be employed on the ECG to detect prediabetes and type 2 diabetes in people with a high risk of contracting the disease. Families with at least one diagnosis of type 2 diabetes living in Nagpur in India were included for the research. Participants gave details about their family and personal medical background, their diet, and went through a comprehensive range of blood tests as well as clinical tests. The average age was 48, and 61% were women. Diabetes and prediabetes were recognized using the diagnostic criteria established by the American Diabetes Association. A typical 12-lead ECG heart track running for 10 seconds was recorded on each participant. A total of 100 unique functional and structural features in each trace were compiled for each one of the 10,461 heartbeats that were recorded to create the predictive algorithm called diabetes. Based on the size and shape of heartbeats in each individual, the diabetes algorithm was able to detect prediabetes and diabetes with an overall precision of 97% and an accuracy of 97%. This was independent of the influence of factors such as gender, age, and other existing metabolic conditions. New AI system to identify potentially cancerous lesions among people who suffer from inflammatory bowel disease. In this study, researchers of Okayama University wanted to see how they could measure how well the AI system they created performed in comparison to conventional endoscopy for classifying lesions that occur in patients with IBD. Lesions that are referred to as IBD neoplasia are abnormal cell growth that could cause cancer. First, the team developed the AI system with 862 images of endoscopic IBD lesions that were seen in patients with IBD. Researchers then sought out endoscopists who had more than 8 years of experience in gastrointestinal endoscopy to review the images and to classify lesions into two categories. One type of lesions can often prompt a doctor to suggest a proctocolectomy, which is a procedure to eliminate the bulk of the large intestine. In the pilot study, researchers discovered that the artificial intelligence system had the image-based diagnostic capability with a sensitivity of 64% with 89% precision and 80% accuracy. This AI system also has a lesion-based diagnostic ability of 74% sensitivity, 85% specificity, and an accuracy of 80%. Furthermore, the AI system has 79% accuracy in diagnosing images of lesions, whereas the human endoscopists have 77% accuracy. Researchers feel confident that the AI system is of sufficient value to help in the next phase of clinical practices.